think the entire team today is very fortunate to share our perspective, how we will evolve our PLM strategy and explain the role of the cloud going forward. Because the cloud will change how our customers, how you will develop and formulate innovative and sustainable products. In an environment where today's supply chain struggles to meet demand and all of our customers expect fast innovation cycles, it is essential to rethink the current way of working in product development. So the objective of today's webinar is to explain how we address the challenges with our SAP Enterprise product development portfolio and provide you a deep dive on the solution itself. We will focus on both discrete and process industries in this presentation and focus on the idea to market business business process. For this webinar, we will also look into SAP Enterprise product development from the perspective of three different personas. As a team, John, Tom, and Eva look to accelerate profitable top-line growth through the voice of customer and the ability to improve custom product demand. They are looking to increase time to market through a flexible data models across the extended enterprise. And they have a goal to develop the sustainable products we as end consumers also learn to love. To capture this value, all of the three personas, Tom, John, and Eva, have a unique needs for a next generation product lifecycle management system. Understanding the underlying challenges of these personas, right, is extremely important to understand the true nature of SAP Enterprise product development. And that is exactly where we will begin today's journey with. As you can imagine, defining the products that the end customers want is a very complex exercise. Tom, as our head of product management in the storyline today, needs to collect ideas that represent the voice of a customer. He needs to collect ideas that reflect the market reality, and he needs to capture insights from downstream systems, such as sales data, quality issues, failure modes, and many more insights. Our research indicates that people like Tom and his team members struggle to consolidate these insights. As a result, they always struggle to evaluate and reliably predict the impact of a new idea. In a few minutes, we will show how SAP Enterprise Product Development can support Tom and other product managers to address these challenges and drive value by ensuring higher launch success rates, detect non-valuable ideas, and improve the product and brand experience. Developing high-quality, compliant, individualized, and also sustainable products is a huge challenge for John. To achieve this, he needs to have a single source of truth for all product data based on a flexible data model to cope with increasing complexity. Additionally, he needs to orchestrate all the business processes and bring the extended enterprise together. Our user research for R&D personas, like for John, indicate that the accelerating innovation cycles, the changing regulatory environments, and complex IT landscapes often reduce the product success. In the deep dive, we will explain how John and R&D personas in his team can leverage SAP Enterprise product development to improve the collaboration and ensure an alignment with LOBs like manufacturing operations to fulfill custom product demand with fast time to market. Our last persona, Eva, our chief digital officer in the story, has the difficult exercise to drive new business models, leverage new technologies to drive financial synergies, and also showcase digital innovations. As a digitalist champion, she needs to overcome the barrier of legacy systems, functional silos, and also address the problem of the lack of digital talents in the software industry. In this deep dive, we will explain how Eva and her team can leverage SAP Enterprise Product Development to address all of these challenges and improve the collaboration between development, manufacturing, and asset management. And we will also highlight how Eva can drive new business models and with that also increase customer satisfaction. Okay. So together with SAP Enterprise Product Development represents the foundation of our cloud strategy in PLM. Through an out-of-the-box integration between S/4HANA and SAP Enterprise Product Development, we enable a highly integrated idea-to-market business process where we enable our customers to define, develop, and deliver innovative and sustainable products. Let me roll a little video.
Customers know what they want. Do you? And are you able to give it to them? Because that's how you beat the competition. And to do so, you need a digital product innovation strategy. So bring it on with SAP Enterprise Product Development. This cloud solution supports digital development teams to define, develop, and deliver intelligent and sustainable products by creating an ever-evolving design-to-operate value chain for a product development based on customer behavior and needs. SAP Enterprise Product Development feeds data from various sources such as customer feedback, sensors, and SAP S/4HANA back into product development in a closed loop. The solution links product development teams with all downstream operations across the extended enterprise for an ongoing collaborative product innovation process. In the first step, it helps you to identify product experience gaps through an integration with Qualtrics. The identified needs are then used to create detailed requirements and drive a model-based product development approach. The impact of a product change on the digital supply chain can be evaluated in every step of the product development process. During development, collaboration within and across company borders is easy, be it working together on product structures, specifications, or documents. Use the Ariba Business Network to seamlessly exchange product data for an integrated digital thread. Plus, you can also develop digital twins of your products and manufacturing plants, reusing engineering models. The digital twins connected with the IoT enable the analysis of real-time data during operations for product improvement decisions and predictive maintenance. The digital twins can also be monetized, creating innovative as-a-service models through an integration with SAP subscription billing. And by leveraging 2D and 3D visualizations in interactive spare parts catalogs, you can further grow your aftermarket sales and maximize customer satisfaction. With SAP Enterprise Product Development, you innovate products that make a difference, increasing revenue, reducing development costs, and designing the sustainable products your customers will love. Get started today with a free trial.
Awesome. So in summary, we want to enable our customers in discrete and process industries to define, develop, and deliver innovative and sustainable products. And for that, we are enabling the next generation product lifecycle management process, where we help you to bring new ideas to market. I'd like to invite Carsten now to join me now and talk about the how SAP Enterprise Product Development is enabling the next generation idea to market process. With that, Carsten, over to you.
So first of all, a warm welcome from my side. And EPD is an exciting journey, and I'm really happy to see on the mentee how many of you already have already touched EPD and how many have heard about EPD, but equally, how many are curious to learn more about EPD. So as I said, for me as an engineering lead, EPD is an exciting journey. When we say it's a cloud-native product, we have to reflect, what does it mean? We start typically with a product that is meeting requirements, and then we use advantages of EPD, of cloud technologies, to grow it fast. So I think we have seen for all which are using EPD or which are following EPD, over a quarter, we're adding new releases, new features, and those increments are getting shorter and shorter. But cloud native means also we expect from the product an exciting onboarding journey, an exciting user journey. So we worked hard to make the onboarding experience as simple as possible, not only from a technical perspective. We also provide, if you watch YouTube and so on, we provide step-by-step guides, tutorials to make this as painless, as redefined, as easy as possible. On the other side, a cloud product never stands for its alone. So for us, the main reason, the main benefit we can bring as PLM team to our customers is integration of PLM data, of product development data into the downstream business process. So we care very much in the beginning of each product on the integration with S4HANA, typically on-premise as well as cloud. If you look into the collaboration, into document collaboration, into visualization, into all the other topics we are presenting later, we will again and again see this integration with S4HANA. Nevertheless, we are also recognizing the fact that not all customers are on S4HANA yet. So wherever possible, we make it as seamless as possible to integrate also with lower ERP releases enhancement packages. And this integration allows us to use basically data from product development on the one side to downstream processes. On the other side, leverage the features like collaboration from S4, bring those information from S4 into the cloud. When we started with EPD, originally it was four different services, four different so-called capabilities, which we launched EPD with. Now, over the last quarters, EPD has grown. We launched the intelligent handover capability. And you will see in the course of this presentation that we are launching exciting new capabilities. On the other side, so it's basically a suite, but no customer starts with everything at the same time. So we built EPD in a very modular way. You can switch on, you decide what you want to start with, and you can change, you can extend this at any time. And making the consumption of the things we provide as flawless, as simple as possible. Then what you saw in the video, and I think what also Ismail illustrated too, we are trying to expand a little bit the boundaries of PLM. We are aiming to provide a closed loop experience. When you define requirements for a product, ideally, we have to take market insights into account. And we are aiming to provide those market insights. You also will see later that we provide innovation management as part of EPD. So it means ideas from your colleagues can become part of the product development, part of the innovation process. But we don't stop there. As connected products, we also try to get insights into how the product is used and basically allow the optimization of products which have been developed to go into new iterations. And last but not least, and this is equally exciting for me as an engineer, we aim to use new technologies wherever they provide a benefit to the product. So one paradigm we told us is wherever possible, as example for discrete industries or for packaging, use visualization. One exciting topic for me is visual analytics, where you see the product in 3D and tag it with business information to gain insights about the product. And this is for me one of the main benefits of product development. Make data, make visualizations accessible for downstream business processes. In addition, we manage IoT data. We manage, as example, in requirements management, machine learning to improve, to make basically processes, repetitive processes, as simple as possible. The future, I think, is equally exciting. So in the past, we provided four releases for EPD per year. We have now laid the foundations that we go to so-called continuous feature delivery or micro deliveries. That means we will see smaller increments, smaller deliveries. And of course, this on the one side even reduces the time to market for innovations we provide. We can react faster on your needs. But on the other side, it makes changes also less disruptive. So that means the risk for any regression will go down even more. And this is for me, from a technology, from an engineering perspective, the exciting journey that we see with enterprise product development.